It's a common trope encountered in pop culture and literature. A gay male best friend and a straight female. We see it in Will and Grace, we see it in Modern Family, although in brother-sister relationship, we see it literally all over. A quick Google search shows that GBF, or the gay best friend, is a common thing. So I did a little searching through the literature, and it turns out that it also is something that scientists and psychologists have been interested in as well. And the term fruit flies or fag hags as the straight female best friend of the gay male has commonly been called. You can see it in as early as 1976, they have appeared in psychology, 1980, 1990. But all of these studies don't actually really get at the question of why GBF exists or in what context. And so, Why and When Straight Women Trust Gay Men, Ulterior Mating Motives in Female Competition was a study that came out in 2017, and it tried to answer this question. So there are a lot of studies that this group of scientists from the University of Texas, that they tried to do. They did four studies, but each of them would literally take 10 minutes and would be an hour. So I focused on two of them. The first one is, are women's trust in gay men rooted in the mating domain? Basically, what this study sought to figure out is when and where and why do straight females trust gay men, and does it only have to do with mating? So, the two main hypotheses from this study. A gay male target's mating advice would be more trusted by the straight female than advice offered from a heterosexual male or a female. And that there would be no difference in any advice proffered by the gay male in non-mating domain. So this is advice in terms of the category of career or anything besides mating. So how did they do this? They did this by taking a bunch of females, 167, from a large college campus that went unnamed, and they tried to do a pretty good job at getting a diverse demographic. Then what they did is they created three fake Facebook profiles. The first one was of a straight girl. The second one was of a heterosexual male. And the third was of a gay male, but the gag was that the straight male and the gay male had the same picture. And for the Facebook profiles, the straight women were given three pieces of information. The picture, again, the same for the gay male and the straight male, their gender, female or male, and their sexual orientation. Then, this is where things get interesting. So they were sorted into three different groups. And then they were given ten different scenarios. The first one, five had to do with, the woman was said, imagine that you're in a bar and that you meet the guy of your dreams and he's sitting right across from you. And you have one person to ask, and that person that you have to ask is the person from the Facebook profile. And then they said, imagine that this person is giving you advice on the opposite end. So imagine that the straight woman, who's like your hotline, is saying, I don't think he's into you, I would pursue someone else. Imagine the gay man saying that, imagine the straight man saying that. And then they were given, that was the bar scenario, was one of them. And then the other one was they were placed in a workspace. And the opposite was true for the workspace. So instead of, I don't think this guy is good for you, I don't really think he's into you, it was, I don't think this is the company is a good fit for you, I would apply elsewhere. And those same lines were said by the straight woman, or they would have imagined straight woman, gay male, or the straight male. And then they were given a scale from 1 to 7, and they said, how trusting were you of this advice? And so, as you can see, it's pretty significant. The woman trusts straight men the least. And then in the middle were their female competitors, but gay men, in terms of mating, truly significant, and even as well as in career advice. So this is where things get interesting. The researchers clearly saw that gay men were more trusted. But the fact they were also more trusted in the career advice meant, okay, do women trust gay men more in terms of just in general, or is it specifically located to the mating advice? So they went one step further, and this is where we go to study three, the effect of mating competition on trust in gay men. So the hypothesis here was that if you make competition extra salient to women, if you literally prime them to be concerned about their female competitors, how would they then situate themselves to gay men and then to straight women? So they took out the straight men from the three, and then there was just the two of them. So, what that means is they basically try to replicate the same, even more diverse demographics, even more female undergraduates from the same university. And the female undergraduates were sorted into two different groups. The first group was given, the researchers made fake articles. And the first article had the headline, "Where Have All the Good Men Gone?" And it basically was an article that was like, it was fakely generated by the college newspaper. And it was a piece, a profile, on how there were no more straight good men in the college campus that they were in, and that the women kind of had it, you know, they had to be competitive. So that was the University of Texas at Austin. And that was one article. The second one was just a plain old article about night owls and having more nightmares. And so the two groups were asked to read this article. And they were said that they would be tested at the end of the article, so they had to read it really fast and within a given certain period of time and absorb the information. Then, after they were asked to read those two articles, they were shown two profiles, a straight girl, a gay guy. Then they were given five scenarios. And they were basically, the scenarios were, okay, imagine you see a really hot guy, and then you have spinach in your teeth. Who would you trust to tell you to take away the spinach? This, like, truly simple things like that, a lot more explicit and transparent than the first study. And there were five similar things. And it was, the workplace was just excised, it was just strictly, like, meeting. And even more than last time, they found that the control group was the night owls, and the competition group was just the other article. And they found that, even more so, women trusted gay men in terms of what advice that they offered. So the main takeaway, especially from a human evolutionary biology standpoint, and the main takeaway from the article, was that there actually is something very, very significant in the relationship between a gay male and a straight female best friend. And even more so, I want to bring attention to the modern family relationship. Some, the article was saying, maybe in the future we'll see that there will be more pairings of like the straight male, the gay male brother and the straight male sister, and that dynamic and how that plays out, and whether straight sisters have a higher advantage in the mating world because they might have gay brothers. And that was the next takeaway from this article. And I guess basically the limitations of this is that it was just focused on college campuses, which I think foster a unique relationship between gay males and straight females. Also, their other age groups, it was the median age for all of those studies was 19, and it was just located on college campuses. And also, I think a fascinating thing would be whether over time a female's trust in a gay male might be situated in the mating domain, but over time would it expand to other domains like career if they have a relationship that takes place over, you know, 10, 15 years. And that's that.